Hey guys, Music Leaders here today, and I'm back with another video. Now, today's video, we're going to react to I Prevail's song called The Negative from their newest album, True Power. I'm almost done with this album. I think I have like three songs left. After this, I'm going to have three songs left. I'm interested to see what they're going to do with the last song, a few songs. This song is not that long. It's only 2 minutes and 20 seconds. A lot of the songs on this album have been under 3 minutes or barely over 3 minutes, which is quite interesting. You know, I've said it before, shorter songs, you can, you know, it gets more to the point and the chorus doesn't linger on for too long. But also, if a song is good, you want to hear for longer. So if it's like less than 3 minutes, it could be a downer for a lot of people. Sorry for that, there's an airplane flying above, I can't do anything about that. This album's been quite interesting. I don't know what to fully think of it before I finish it. I'm gonna probably re-listen to all the songs again on my own, back to back, to see how I feel about it. But for right now, there's some songs I really enjoy, some other songs I forgot about, because like I said, I stopped doing it for a while because of, you know, I didn't see people really viewing these, and there's a lot of copyright claims, which I'm still getting, but I'm fine with it. And I was just making videos that more majority of people wanted to see, so yeah. But before I get into this video, I do want to give a big shout out once again to Dark Mike 85's Dark World. I gave him a shout out in the last video, just in case he didn't see that. I'll put it in this video too. Big thank you to you, because I only need one more subscriber to hit 100 mark. That's a big goal of mine. As a YouTuber, you want to hit the 1,000 mark for the subscriber count, you know, to get monetized. But you also need like 4,000 hours or watch hours and stuff. I think I'm like 1/8 of the way done with that, but this one, it'll put me at 1/10 of the way of the subscriber count, which is really amazing. And this channel hasn't even been around for a year. At most, I think it's been around for like 6 months or maybe a little bit less, and I've already hit close to hitting the 100 subscriber mark. So big thank you to all of you guys for, you know, viewing my videos and liking and commenting, because that does help out my videos to get higher in the YouTube algorithms. It gets it out for more people to come in and enjoy it. So yeah, sorry for the long-winded intro. I just want to give you guys a big thank you and, you know, explain more about, you know, the situation with this. So yeah, let's get into it. I'm on the edge tonight, closer to the ledge of right. Lost in my head tonight, lost in my head tonight. I'm spinning in circles and I can't get out. Running from these thoughts that I can't say out loud. Well damn, I guess you're the perfect person. Same thing but a different version. Paint the picture but you don't deserve it. Your color's fading underneath the surface. Swear black everywhere you go. No take backs at the end of the road. No last chance till the cats are closed. Your silence is worth more than gold. I'm so sick and tired. We're almost done with the song. It's short, but I'm really liking it. It's the original style that they usually do, you know, clean rock vocals with screaming in and, you know, heavy instrumentals. But I like this. It depends. You can do the same style, and I think it's fine to do it as long as you do it good. And this one is a really good version of, you know, how they normally do it. It has a lot of energy to it. It has a lot of pop to it. The drums are coming in heavy. The vocals are super clean. They sound super nice, especially for the chorus. The screaming sounds very well too. like, you can have, the thing about me, I like a rough scream, but I also like a clean scream. If you can have a nice clean scream, it works very well. People think that, like, when you like screaming in a song, like a rock song, they always have to be like, you know, growls and stuff, like, and it's like, yeah, that can work, but not every scream has to be like rough and like a growl. It can be also a smooth scream, which just pumps up the energy, kind of like in the song Dead on Arrival, when they were singing that and he was screaming, "I can't breathe." That part was amazing. That gave it so much, you know, oomph, and it gave so much emphasis to that line, because that line was important because of what was happening. I mean, still happening now, but especially what happened at that time with, you know, George Floyd and stuff. So that really amplified that, you know, that line, and made it have more of a meaning, more deep. So when they do that and scream it out and stuff, and it's clear, it speaks more to you. So that's what I like about, you know, his screams. He can have the rough, you know, tough one, but he can also have like a strong, powerfully clean, you know, scream in it, which just works very well.
So sick and tired of the negative black and white, you're right, I'm fucking over it.
So that was I Prevail's The Negative. I really liked it. It was nothing too special. It was like, you know, the original, like, unique style that they normally do, but it was done very well. I don't need a song to be amazing, like I said before. It doesn't need to be crazy and outstanding. It just needs to have something that, you know, a lot of artists have their own lane that they go into, and that lane is good, but the difference between going in that lane and making it, you know, just repetitive and generic, and going into that lane and making it, you know, unique, is definitely the way you handle the song and the vibe to it, and the, like, the amount of energy you put into it. And this song had quite a bit of great energy. I'm really liking this. Besides the deep, the last two songs were kind of more of a letdown. Choke wasn't too bad, but they weren't too great either. But this song's really great. And now that we have three songs left, hopefully that these three songs, you know, are amazing. Because I really love this band. I really appreciate them. And I want to like all their music. Obviously, you're not going to end up liking everybody's music, but at least you want to like majority of it. So I'm hoping that the last three songs are, you know, amazing and killer. But for right now, I think Body Bag, Bad Things, and Deep End are easily my favorite songs from this album. But who knows, maybe the last three songs might, you know, blow my perception out of water. So yeah, once when I'm done with that, I'll definitely get on to the review of this album. It has been quite a tricky process and stuff. I do want to review albums of other bands and, you know, react to all the songs, but I also don't want to deal with a bunch of, you know, blocking and stuff. It wasn't fully blocked, it's partially blocked, but even then, it makes it hard for a lot of viewers to go watch it. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and stay tuned for next time.